a folk hero named Till Eulenspiegel.
Oh.
And his stories are enlightening, amusing, entertaining, a source of wisdom. He's a trickster who is sometimes the one who tricks, and sometimes the one who falls victim to his own plots. But this, one of the shortest period stories that I know, is the tale of Till Eulenspiegel and the Three Baptisms, which shows how such an unusual character got his start. Well, mother and father were greatly pleased, for their baby was born and thriving. Young Till, and soon he was to be taken to the church for his baptism. Well, the family gathered at the home and took him to the church, where he was dunked beneath the water, and in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, he was baptized in the usual way. This was the first of Till Eulenspiegel's baptisms. On the way home, the party making its way and congratulating mother and father with great fervor, they found themselves laden down with gifts and with well wishes and cousins coming to hug them. And so they unburdened themselves, handing the baby to the nursemaid. The nursemaid did her job as well as she could, bearing the babe. But soon, as they approached the creek, when the party went to step onto the bridge, the nursemaid was jostled. She took a step to the side and slipped in the mud, falling down into the water.
Sploosh.
Sploosh. Muck and frogs everywhere. Nursemaid and babe dunked in the water. Now this was the second baptism of Till Eulenspiegel on the very same day. Soon the nursemaid and babe were hauled up to the top of the bank once again, and the party made its way home. But it would not do for the young guest of honor to be shown to all the town in muddy dress, with weeds in his hair, and so a great tub was drowned out, and more water heated, this cleaner than the last. And soon, the babe was dunked and swished, and plunged beneath the water and pulled out again, clean of all stain. Now this, my friends, was the third baptism of Till Eulenspiegel. Portending great and unusual things.